Hi, welcome to Jill's Journals number 11, and this is a special one to my family and friends to let you know I got sort of here and what's been happening and to give you an update. So as you can see, I'm sitting in my trailer. I'm still in my same three outfits. I can't put on makeup. I can barely brush my hair. I had my first cup of real coffee this morning, and we're 3 weeks into the adventure. So it's been quite an adventure, but I wanted to say hello, that I'm here safe, that I had a few bumps and things happen along the way, and nothing has turned out the way I had planned it. I did get to farm number one, so in a few minutes I'll show you how that went and what we can see. And if you're watching the blog, you know I'm in Buckhorn, New Mexico, which is a tiny town of, 150, and it has two businesses and a post office, which most of the towns up and down this highway, that's pretty much all they have. I'm about 30 some odd miles from Silver City, which is another 40 miles from the 10. So I'm kind of in a remote area, but I'm in a beautiful valley that is quite special, and it's full of unique people. So I'm kind of excited about staying here for a while. There have been some issues with the trailer that is documented more in the blog. If you go to jillelizabeth.net, you can link from there and get some pictures about what's wrong with the trailer. I still haven't documented the full experience, but some of the blog dates have some of what happened. So I wanted to say hi. I want to say thank you again for everybody who helped and support me get this far. And I have been met again here with nothing but wonderful, helpful, gracious people who have all been generous with their time and their wisdom and their assistance along the way, because I will say it now and I will keep saying it, no one gets to their dreams alone, and it's only by helping each other that we've really get anywhere. And that is what people have done every step of the way. They've been just generous and helpful. And the plans now are, I think I'm going to be staying here for a while, because I am getting clearer that I'm just not ready. I have too much stuff. I don't know how to get organized. You can't see it, but this whole thing is a mess, and I even have half of the trailer unloaded. I can't find anything. I can sleep and the cats are okay, but that's about it. And I'm happy to report the cats have done really, really well for such a difficult transition. Even my boy cat, who can't tolerate anything, has done spectacularly. They're both happy, they're healthy, they've found their way, and we're on to the adventure. So my plan is to plant myself here for a little while. I have a new friend who's going to let me stay at her house. So I will have internet, a bathroom, and a kitchen, in addition to trying to manage this trailer. So I'll be living in the best of both worlds for now, because I'm not 100% ready to transition into the trailer 100%. The trailer is designed, I've learned, for off-grid living with absolutely no resources, but if you can plug in and you have water, it's just not really coping very well. So I can't say that I'm completely unhappy about the fact that I will still have access to a bathroom and a shower and a kitchen and laundry, because, you know, I'm still not 100% ready to go off the grid. But if need be, I am ready. So here is a little bit about my first farm adventure. This is Bitsy. Hi, Bitsy. Do you want to go for your swim? And then I want to show you. So, good morning. I want to show you the turkey. Here we go. This is Bart. Hey, Bart. Can I say hi? This is Bart. Here's some little chickens. I want to show you Bart's face. Hi, Bart. I already forgot what kind he is. Say hi, Bart. And we've got little chickens. See, he's got the most interesting face. Can you see that? There's the dog. You can see there are all kinds of land. And there's the chicken coop. This little guy right here is about 3 months old. We think he's a rooster because now he's crowing. You want to say hi?
Hi, little guy.
He's not allowed out yet. There's the little guy. And this is the chicken coop. Chickens get out for the day. And then we have horses. So we have, these are the big horses. So it's the big horse. Now we have two little horses and the big horses. And they're eating. Hey, little guys. And then there's another vegetable garden out there. And that's the perimeter. It's really pretty. You see the mountains?